We talk about a crisis coming, and indeed there is, and it's one in which we're in danger of being swept away by the spirit of non-abidance. There's either the spirit of non-abidance or the spirit of abidance. That's it. Spirit of non-abidance is like putting lipstick on non-abidance. That's what it does. It puts lipstick on non-abidance. And you know how the lipstick drawer can just get more and 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 it's like that. Whereas the spirit of abidance doesn't need any of that lipstick, no. So this is the crisis that is coming. Now, we get what we ask for. We've heard that, and it's true. Most are asking for non-abidance. They just want a better shade of lipstick for it. If you ask for spirit of abidance, you will get it. So I asked for this morning, and I received this response that it's very soon, you will have it. I said, that's all I want. That's all that I want. I don't want anything other than that. Just that, the spirit of abidance. The spirit of abidance. So, again, it's very important to keep restating this, that the crisis is to be swept away into manias of this and this and this and this and this and this and this. So I'm showing that we can at least still be part of the world doing our nutrition, our exercise, our various things, but still be in the spirit of abidance. So we don't feel like we're just completely withdrawn into a cave or something. And the spirit of abidance helps us avoid getting swept away. It's like we're on the beach and here comes a tsunami and it sweeps everyone out to this vast ocean of non-abidance and defending that from abidance. You see, our natural condition is abidance, the spirit of abidance. And so if we don't want that, we have to be ceaselessly trying to avoid it. And no matter what we do, the mood seems to be coming back to us. So we're always changing. It never ends. It never ends. It's a massive defensive operation. And that's all that it is. So this gets really tiresome, doesn't it? To be continuously in the spirit of defensiveness, having to change and adjust. Oh, here it comes again. Oh, it's coming from this angle. Paranoid, fearful. It's going to get me. Read a quote today, nobody gets out of here alive. And I say, wait a minute. The only way to get out of here is alive. Nobody gets out of here dead. But we certainly get out of here alive. That's the only way. So, the spirit of abidance is you want just that. And the spirit of non-abidance is this constant play of defensiveness, which we try to put lipstick on that pig, but that's just never ending, isn't it? Yeah. And this is what I see. This is what the world is like. It's like that. People are desperate. You know, something's about to get me. You know, I'm afraid it's death or something. Not abidance thinks that abidance is death. Some sort of spiritual death. No, it's abidance, the spirit of abidance. It's not death. It's the spirit of abidance. It's not nothing. It's the spirit of abidance. And we don't need to define it any more than that. Actually, that's what it is. Just as the spirit of non-abidance is that. And our trouble is to think that somehow we are a blank slate and we can be whatever, that there's nothing natural to us. No, that's not true. We are created by the Creator with this spirit of abidance. And so that is what is natural to us. So what is natural to us, always we feel that is it, you know, that's it. And so when we want to try and separate from that, we're always going to have to be fearful. There's no way around it. And we try to go to, you know, nihilism, atheism, all these different isms, communism, socialism, capitalism, all this stuff, ism, to try and get away from that. But it's not possible. We want to deny it. We say, no, there's no natural state. It's whatever I want it to be. Well, that's not true. And we think we can have both abidance and non-abidance. That is not true. It's not true at all. And so we just keep jumping through all these hoops. This, and then we call this a life. No. It's a struggle against life. We don't have a life here. Most people don't have a life. They have a struggle against life. Life is how God created life, which is the spirit of abidance. That's life. And the spirit of non-abidance is a struggle to avoid life, against life. And that's all that it is. That's all that it is. Withdrawing to a room is not the spirit of abidance. Withdrawing to a depression is not the spirit of abidance. It's putting lipstick on the spirit of non-abidance. They're saying, what can I do with that spirit of abidance? You know, it's really causing me problems, so let me stick it into a depression, into a room, into, you know, like that, and then you find yourself in that condition. The ferocious ocean of the spirit of non-abidance, lost at sea, no place to be. I'm not exercising this morning so much. My knees and are a little sore. I'll do something, but I've been hitting it so hard. You know, at some point you give it a little time to body to catch up, I would say, but we'll see. So I'm taping first today. I did my stretching some, but taping first here. So make sure that we get this. So, I asked my guru, Longchenpa, for the spirit of abidance. Done deal. If you ask him, whatever you ask him for, he's going to deliver it. He will deliver it. So I have faith in that. It's easy. He fixed my golf swing in 10 minutes. I've been working on it for 44 years. He said, just like this, to just do this. I say, it's fixed, it's true. No, but no, no one else is going to swing that way. Not likely, right? But it's fixed, which is what I asked for. So, if he can fix my golf swing, he can fix my abidance issue too. I've been struggling my whole life for abidance. So I have faith that Longchenpa can fix that also. That's the grace of the guru. But you have to ask for it. See, I asked for it. You have to ask for it. If you ask, can you put, ask for, you know, better lipstick on the pig, that's what you'll get. The spirit of abidance is how I'm phrasing it. The spirit of abidance. Not a definition of abidance, the spirit of abidance. So it's an exciting time for me. Great time. When you ask the guru, you will receive. So I'm you know, humbly in this mode of realizing here it comes. He will get it done. These super gurus, these Dharma kings, are beyond what we normally consider to be gurus, spiritual teachers, and sages, and all of that. Greater potency, for sure. If you ask them, you will most definitely receive it. And you get blessed by a Dharma King, Super Guru, when you decide that you're truly serious and you do want to receive the spirit of abidance. Then, there they are. Again, there's only two options, either the spirit of abidance or the spirit of non-abidance. That's it. It's very simple, isn't it? So, mentally, I'm preparing myself for this, and the spirit of non-abidance says, well, that's death, it's death. No, it's the ending of the spirit of non-abidance. It's the ending of non-abidance, that's all. But it is the spirit of abidance is what it is. It doesn't view itself as an ending of something. It simply is what it is. That which has no beginning nor ending. So here it comes. That's how I feel. That's the confidence I have in Longchenpa. Here it comes. Here comes the spirit of abidance. Very great. And we'll just allow it to come. And it'll be very helpful for those who don't really want to get dragged into this madness that's coming. It's the storm has built. It's been building for a long time. Stormy seas. And there's all sorts of roles played in this spirit of non-abidance, all sorts of guides and teachers and leading this way and leading that way and all illusions, you know, it just leads, go around aimlessly in circles and you get all more confused and baffled and what's wrong, I don't quite understand, I can't get this, I can't get that. All defensiveness, actually, all defending against what is natural to us, the spirit of abidance. All trying to avoid that and telling ourselves we get some reward for avoiding it. No, we don't. There's no reward for avoiding it. We imagine all these rewards and try to pretend we have all these rewards, but it's still the same fear. We're rewarded with fear. That's it. Ramana Maharshi said, "You all want many things. I want just one thing, the spirit of abidance. That's all he wanted." And the rest of us, we want defensiveness. Really, the massive ocean of fear and defensiveness, chasing after different shade of lipstick to dress it up with. Say, "Oh, look how pretty beautiful it looks." This fear. It's very simple. That's all there is to it. So, I feel good. I mean, it's amazing how good I feel with all the exercise I've been doing. But, you know, it's great. So, everything's great. And just let the spirit of abidance come. And just take it from there. Very simple. Okay, that's it for this one.